ओम सदाशिव समारंभां शंकराचार्य मध्यमां अस्मदाचार्य पर्यंतां वंदे गुरु परंपरां ओम। वी कम टू द वेरी क्रिटिकल पार्ट ऑफ विश्वरूप ईश्वर दर्शन। स्पेसिफिकली दीज वर्सेस वेयर अर्जुनस हार्ट हैज बीन ओपन्ड अप इनटू भक्ति एंड वेरी फॉर्चुनेटली वेंकटेश प्रसाद हैज सिलेक्टेड दीज वर्सेस फॉर अस टू चांट रिपीटेडली इन ईच क्लास टू ब्रिंग अबाउट bhakti in our hearts. Essentially, if this chapter opens up bhakti in our heart and it prepares us for the next chapter, the bhakti is the shortcut to God realization. And let us dedicate all our efforts to understanding these verses. I will request Prasanna to explain the first verse. Prasanna, your time starts.
Hari Om, sir. Can you hear me, sir?
Yes, please go ahead.
Chapter 11,
verse 38. Tomadi Deva Purushaha Purana Samasya Vishvasya Param Nidanam Vetasya Vedyancha Paramcha Dama Tvaya Tatam Vishvam Anantarupa. The translation goes as follows. You are the primal God, the ancient Purusha. You are the supreme ground of dissolution of this universe. You are the knower, the known, as well as the abode, which is beyond both the knower and the known. The universe is pervaded by you, O Lord, with endless forms. In the eyes of Arjuna, Lord Krishna's stature is increasing. Arjuna's understanding of Ishvara becomes clearer and clearer as this chapter unfolds, and his devotion also becomes deeper and deeper. Arjuna expresses that devotion here. Swam Adideva Purusha Purana. Adideva here is referred to as Vishnu. Purusha, everything is pervaded with divinity. You are the all pervading one, and also you are the indweller in every living being. Purusha has two meanings, the one who is all pervading, and the second meaning is the one who resides in the body. Purusha, body, sa means indweller. So Purusha means the indweller in everybody. Purana, you are the most ancient one without a beginning. Then Swamasya Vishvasya Param Dana, you are the supreme ground of dissolution of this universe. In the scriptures, it is described that during pralayam, all living being resolves into prithvi. Prithvi itself dissolves into jalam. Jalam into the agni tattvam. Agni into vayu tattvam. Vayu into akasha tattvam. And akasha into brahma tattvam. Brahma does not resolve into anything. And therefore, it is called the ultimate resolution ground. Param nidhanam. Vetasi vedyam cha. The sentient, experiencing, living being are called Veta, and the insentient object of experience is the Vedyam. So one is Pramata, another is Pramayam. In fact, the whole creation is a mixture of the Chetana and Achetana Tattvam. Arjuna says, Krishna, you are the knower of everything. You are the experiencer of the world. You are the expression of this Vishwa. You are the support. When you stop expressing, the world collapses and there will be no Vishwa. Bhagwan is the support of this Vishwa. It is like a dancer. When a person is dancing, we see a beautiful dance, a wonderful dance. And after some time, the dancer sits quietly. You look everywhere. Where is the dance? The dance was there in the dancer, and the dance was supported by the dancer. The dance cannot exist without the dancer, but the dancer can exist without dance. The world is the dance of the God, and the whole world is supported by this cosmic reality. Arjuna goes on to tell Krishna, not only are you Pramata and Prameyam, you are Paramcha Dama. You are beyond the Chetana, Achetana Tattvam. You are the ultimate reality. You are the absolute consciousness. You are in which all the knower and as well as the
Shadi kare something is wrong with her machakya
shall I continue sir
Prasanna, you can please continue. I will mute the. I think somebody has come out of the mute.
You are in which all the knowers and as well as the object of knowledge rest. In the short, Tvaya Tatam Vishvam Ananta Rupa. O Lord, the entire universe is pervaded by you. Veta and Vedyam represent the relative world, and Param means the absolute. So Tvaya Tatam Vishwam, he Ananta Rupa, O Vishwarupa Ishvara. Hari Om. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, Prasanna, for a nice explanation. This verse is a very loaded verse. Every word has got a very profound meaning, which Prasanna was able to give it to us. Especially as these verses bring about bhakti, we need to study these verses. We go to the next verse. Sharmila, can you please start?
Hari Om, sir. Can you hear me?
Yes, please. Go ahead.
Chapter 11, verse 39. Vayur Yamo Nir Varunaha Shashankaha Prajapatistvam Prapitamahasya Namo Namaste Stu Sahasra Krutiva Punesha Bhuyopi Namo Namaste. The verse meaning goes like this. You are Vayu, Yama, Varuna, Shashanka, the moon, Prajapati, and the great grandfather. A thousandfold salutations be to you. Salutation be to you again and again. The word meanings. Tvam Vayu. You are Vayu. Yamaha. Yama, the god of death. Agnihi. Agni, the god of fire. Varunaha. Varuna, the god of winds. Shashanka, the moon. Prajapati, the lord of all born beings. Cha Prapitamaha, the great grandfather. Sahasra Kritva, a thousandfold. Namaha Namaha, salutation. Astute, be to you. Punaha Che Buyo Api, again and again. In verse 39, Arjuna surrenders to the Lord when he realizes the Lord's greatness. He understands that the source of nature's power is none other than Lord Krishna. He sees Bhagwan in all the primal forces of nature. Arjuna sees various deities in the cosmic form of Lord Krishna. And he says, you are Vayu, the god of wind, who sustains all living beings. You are Yama, the lord of death, who ensures justice for all. You are Agni, the fire god, who provides energy to all beings. You are Varuna, the lord of the life-giving force, which is water. You are Shashanka, the moon, who nourishes all plants and herbs. So how could the Lord manifest as all these deities? The Vedic texts refer to Brahma as Hiranyagarbha, the golden womb that brought forth the universe. Lord Brahma, the creator, brought all the deities into existence. Swami Param says we should all understand the logic behind the cause and the effect. This logic is given in a particular section of the Brahma Sutra and has been discussed in the previous chapters of the Bhagavad Gita. Bhagwan is the karanam or cause, and the whole creation is the karyam or the effect. The fundamental law is that karanam alone appears in the form of manifold karyam. Cause alone with different names and forms appears as various effects. You have all understood the relationship between gold and ornaments, wood and furniture, wave and ocean. There can be no ornaments separate from gold, no furniture separate from wood, and no waves and ocean separate from water. The cause is God, and there are no creations other than God. This is a powerful logic, and Arjuna applies this logic and says, O Lord, you are the cause alone, are in the form of Vayu, Agni, Varuna, and Shashanka. He calls Bhagwan Prajapati and Prapitamaha, Praja means creation or procreative powers, and Pati means Lord. So Prajapati means Lord of all creatures or Lord of all the born beings. Vishnu creates Brahma, and Brahma creates 14 Prajapatis, and from these Prajapatis, all other human beings are born. Arjuna says that all the Prajapatis are also the Lord. Brahmaji is born out of Vishnu's navel, hence he is Pitamaha or grandfather, and Vishnu becomes Prapitamaha or great grandfather. Arjuna is able to see the Lord as the universe. This is Vishwarupa Darshana. I would like to mention the advantages of this darshana. First benefit is Dvesha Parihara. We do not hate anything, as everything is part of the Lord. We do not divide things into Raga and Dvesha. The next is Amanitvam. All the glory in the world belongs to God. If we have the gift of music or dance, we cannot claim it, as it belongs to God. Hence, Vishwarupa Darshana brings humility. The next one is we look at the whole world as sacred, as it belongs to the Lord. And the last benefit is the expansion of the mind as we begin to appreciate the totality of creation. Arjuna is so overwhelmed when he realizes Lord Krishna is everything that he surrenders to his will. He bows with reverence and salutes the Lord over and over again, more than 1,000 times. Thank you.
Thank you, Sharmila, for a nice explanation of this verse and also the significance of Vishwarupa Ishwara Darshan. The highest form of love is bhakti. And when there is bhakti in your heart, sometimes you cannot express your love. But you see the greatness of Vyasacharya in these words of devotion to the Lord. Captain Guru Mishra, verse 40, please.
Hari Om, Om Gurubhyo Namah. I am blessed to be reciting Adhyaya Gyarva, Shloka Chaliswa. Namaha Purastada Tata Prashtata Te Namostute Sarvata Eva Sarva Ananta Virya Mita Vikrama Tvam Sarvam Sapap Samapanoshi Tatos Ti Sarva. Obeisance to you from the front, from behind, and from all sides. O unbounded power, you are the master of limitless might. You are all pervading, and thus you are everything. Out of loving ecstasy for Krishna, his friend, Arjuna is offering his respects from all sides. He is accepting that he is a master of all potencies and all prowess, and far superior to the great warriors assembled on the battlefield. It is said in the Vishnu Purana, Yo yam dvagato deva samipani devita ganha. Satum eva jagat srasta yata sarvagato bhavan. Whoever comes before you, even if he be demigod, is created by you, O Supreme Personality of Godhead. From Swami Paramstor, Arjun stated, Sarvata eva namaskara. So all around you, I offer namaskara. Sarvata eva te namah astu. Sarva Rupa, who is not in the form of Krishna alone, who is not in the form of Rama alone, but who is in the form of everything in the creation. And that is why we have got Panchabhuta Linga also. You should remember these are all based on this teaching only, Akash Rupena. You alone are in the form of Vayu. You are Agni. You are therefore, I do namaskaram to the Panchabhuta also, because you are everything. And how great you are, Anantaviramas Vikramastvam. You have got infinite strength or power. Omnipotent you are, Anantaviram Yasya. Because any power that is anywhere belongs to you only, in one lightning itself. So much electricity is there, they say. We know how to tap the electricity from one flash of lightning. We can burn. We can provide electricity to a city for 1 year. But the problem is that we do not have the technology to tap. And how many flashes of lightning are coming every second somewhere in the world? Lightning is striking every second. How much power should be there? And all this power belongs to whom? Therefore, Anantavirya, like that you can take. So much power in the creation. All you alone have, and Amitta Vikrama, and you have got enormous valor, courage also. Some people have power but no courage. So they have the power, so they are terrified. Some people have got courage but no power. You have got both Ananta Virya. Amitta Vikrama, Vikrama Tvam. Sarvam Samapanosi. You pervade everything, so the idea of traveling and reaching God should go out of our mind. So when we start religion, our idea is that we have to reach God. And after that, and that too, we have to travel. We have got conditioning, we have got a conditioning that we have to travel to reach God. The 11th chapter should demolish that conditioning. There is no question of reaching God because we are never away from Lord to reach Him. For the one who has got Vishwarupa Darshanam, I have got my birth, my movement, my death, everything on the lap of the Lord only. How many kilometers the wave should travel to reach the ocean? So there is no question of travel. The idea of travel and the idea of distance is gone out of ignorance. It is notional distance. It is neither time-wise distance nor space-wise distance. It is purely ignorance-wise distance. What is time-wise distance? A child wants to become a major. Minor wants to become major. The distance between minor and major is determined by what? Time. The distance is purely ignorance-wise. How do you remove the ignorance distance? Only by knowledge. And therefore, Vishwarupa Darshanam should remove the idea of reaching God because you are Sarvam Samapanosi. All are pervading, and therefore, Tatosi Sarva, and therefore, you are everything. First, I say you parade everything, then I say you're everything. Like saying gold parades all the ornaments. That is statement number one. Then the next statement, there is no question of gold parading all ornaments. In fact, gold is in the form of all ornaments, therefore, Tato Sri Sarva. Hari Om. Dhanyavad.
Thank you. Thank you, Captain Guru Mitra. Another nice verse, nicely explained. Jyoti.
Yes, sir. Hari Om, sir. Hari Om, sir.
Very clear. Go ahead.
Sakheti matva prasabham yaduktam he Krishna he Yadava he Sakheti ajanata mahimanam tavedam maya pradatat prana yenavapi. This is Arjuna's prayer to Sri Krishna for forgiveness. The word meaning from Shankaracharya's commentary is, because I have been a sinner for want of knowledge of thy greatness, therefore whatever was rationally said from carelessness or love, addressing you as O Krishna, O Yadava, O Sakha, looking upon you merely as a friend, ignorant of the greatness of yours, in whatever way I may have insulted you for fun, while at play, at meals, as friends, with friends or alone, I implore you, O immeasurable one, to forgive me for looking at you merely as a friend owing to misconception. Sakheti here is broken up into sir plus khar. Khar refers to age or time, and sir is saman, equal. So they are referred to as of equal age. Iti is thus. Matva is thinking. Prasabham is rudely, rationally. Yaduktam is, yada is whatever. Uktam is said.
Jyoti is not audible.
We lost her voice, I think.
Yeah. Should we proceed?
Akashji, you are same in the same.
We'll proceed.
Yes, sir. Proceed.
Dr. Asha Naik, please.
Hello. Good evening.
Good evening.
Gurudev and Guru Pyodama. This 11th chapter, Arjuna has realized that Lord Krishna's Nija Swarupa, Vishwarupishwara, and Virata Swarupa. He got frightened sometime, and then he realized that Sakshat Lord Krishna has been with him all this while, and he gets into devotion mode. Arjuna feels great deep guilt in his mind, and he feels he should have worshipped him much better way and properly. In fact, he should have not sat along with them on the same table. He should have sat down with a great respect and humbleness. He feels, I should have treated him more properly. I should have not made fun of him, not insulted him. So with all this deep guilt, he surrenders to Lord Krishna and says, O Lord, forgive me. Here also he is not saying, please forgive me. He asks, give your forgiveness for whatever insults and offenses I have done. That is why Swami Param says, our culture is so good, we should not disrespect anyone, even though we know them or we don't know them, whether they are human being or not human being. Like a nature, water we should not contaminate, wayu we should not spoil, animal kingdom also should be treated well. Because in everything, there is a Bhagwan, which already last three verses they have told. So the verse goes like this. Yachcha vaha sarthamasat krutosi viharashayasana bhojaneshu ekatvapyachuta taksamaksham tatkshamae tva mahaprameyam. The meaning of this is, yet the words are very self-explanatory. Yet, that is moreover. Avaha sartham, that is a Sanskrit word, for the sake of fun. That is what, for the fun, Arjuna always made fun of Krishna. Asi askritaha, that is, he is always bullying or playing prank on him, pulling his leg or doing whatever friends do to each other. Vihara shayya asana bhojaneshu. The word is self-explanatory. Vihara means going along with Krishna, he made fun. Shayya, when they're sleeping on each other on the same bed, pulling the bed sheet and all those things. Asanas, sitting together and relaxing and cutting jokes. Bhojaneshu, when they were eating together. Athava eka, all these things, when it was done in privately. Ati atas samaswam, or in public. Achyuta, hey Krishna. Aham shamai, I seek forgiveness. He doesn't say, please forgive me. I seek forgiveness from you. That is what Sanskrit language. Tvam, from you. Aprameya, that is incomprehensible. This is the word always taught by Dr. Hegde, and I would like to ask him to tell something about aprameya. This verse, I take one thing is, he says Lord Krishna is with him and he did not realize and he treated him. In our life, if everyone around us we treat like a Lord Krishna, the whole life will become a swarga or moksha for us. Hari Om. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Ashanayak. Very nice explanation, very nice chanting and enunciation of the Sanskrit words. The word aprameya is that which cannot be objectified. Pramana is the instrument to see the prameyam. Any object that the pramana, that the instrument uses to verify, is the prameyam. That which cannot be objectified is not an object. So if it is not the object, it should be only one thing. And that is the subject. That is the Atman within you. That is a very significant meaning of the word aprameya.
Sir, Hari Om, sir. Yes, sir.
Come, I'll go back to your verse. Go ahead.
Yes, sir. So I'll continue with the verse, sir. Please. Yes, sir. So in Navdha Bhakti also, the eighth bhakti is illustrated as Sakha Bhav. Arjuna and Shri Krishna were distant cousins, childhood friends growing up together, and Arjuna was totally ignorant of Shri Krishna's divine form, his boundless valor, his tremendous majesty. The Vishwarupa Darshana was like a big interval that changed the whole vision. Now Arjuna reflects back that Shri Krishna is not an ordinary jiva, but Ishvara himself, whom he had scolded, criticized, treated with disrespect, whether in fun and frolic, addressing him as Hey Krishna, which means dark-skinned, besides Lord Krishna's name, Hey Yadava, because he was a Yaduvanshi, and Hey Sakha, very casually, and took all the liberty to misbehave. Whether Such wrong notion affect the speech and action and translate into confusion. Hence, after realizing the deeper truth, he evaluates their relationship. They were like two souls and one body. The Mahabharata has many illustrations of their friendship, and one such passage mentions that before the war of Kurukshetra, when Sanjay is sent by Dhritarashtra to examine Arjuna's camp, he sees Arjuna's feet laid in Sri Krishna's lap, and he is astonished and realizes the end of Duryodhana. This illustrates their intimacy. Even Sir's class mentions one example of Swami Dayananda traveling in a flight with a passenger who was traveling from Delhi to Rishikesh and telling him that he is going to visit Swami Dayananda, not knowing that Swamiji was beside him. On reaching Rishikesh, he, after 2 days, when he goes to the ashram, he realizes that he was with Swamiji himself. So this is just a two small illustrations to know the ignorance. And because of this ignorance, Arjuna asks for forgiveness for his ignorance, delusion, negligence from Sri Krishna. Hari Om, sir.
Thank you. Thanks, Jyoti. We enjoyed listening to you. Beautiful verses, nice explanation. Dr. Bhaskar, please go ahead. Verse 43.
Hari Om, sir. I'm audible, sir.
Very clear. Go ahead.
So, recapping the previous verses, in order to further understand the present verse, 11.43, Lord Krishna says, I am the Karmapala Data to all the Jivas. Arjuna understands by now, looks at suffering as Prabhata Karma, the way for a spiritual purifying process. Surrendering his Ragadvesha to Dharma, the Lord himself, becomes real Bhakta, and his Bhakti starts flowing. His attitude to Namaskara, which was a mechanical one previously, changes with a significant inner expression of his attitude to Lord Krishna. He praises the Lord Krishna, as my previous speakers had already explained, as Adideva, Purusha, Purnaha, Layastana, Prakyasthanam, Turiya Chaitanyam, Adikarte, and Arjuna sees Lord Krishna as an imperishable truth, which is beyond cause and effect. So finally, he says, is Prapitamaha, which is beautifully explained by the previous speaker. And finally, he asks forgiveness for the Lord Krishna by saying he is one incomprehensible one. So coming to the verse, the Pitasi is a word which has got a lot of meaning here. So, Pitasya Lokasya Characharasya Tvamasya Pujasya Gurur Garyan Natat Samasya Badikaha Kutanyo Lokatrayepye Pratima Prabhava. So coming to the first line, Asya Characharasya Lokasya Pitahasi. So Pitaha, Pitasi, you are the father, also means Karanam of the entire creation. So the hidden meaning of Pitasi is exposed only if we inquire about the word, the mother here in Pitasi. So the Vedic teaching goes like this. Father and mother are the inseparable one. And one is Brahma Tattva, that is father. Another is Maya Tattva, that is mother. So Vishnu Bhagavan is further explaining how Maya Tattva is placed in the Trinity without being inseparable. So Vakshasthale Stite Lakshmi, Brahmaji keeps Saraswati Devi in the tongue itself. Shiva, still further, half of the body is occupied. So Pitasi means you are the father and mother. Further, here again, we have to see two things with regards to Pitasi. In three stages of Vedic teaching, Bhagavan creates the world. That is Nimitti Karana Ishvara or Ekarupa Ishvara. Second, Bhagavan himself becomes a world. Therefore, world is Bhagavan himself. That is Upadana Karana Ishvara or Aneka Rupa Karana Ishvara. Last, Bhagavan appears on the world without undergoing any changes. That is Vivarta Upadana Ishvara or Arupa Ishvara. So Arjuna says, you are both father of the world and you are the world. So Pitasi means Eka Rupa and Aneka Rupa Ishvara Karana. So to what type of world? So answer is Characharasya. That is Chetana, moving, and Achetana, non-moving. So coming to the second line, Tam Asya Pujascha Guru Guryan. Pujasya means you are the ultimate object of the worship, which is worshipped, who is worshipped by the entire creation. Arjuna's mechanical namaskara also gets better correction here. He says, we never deserve the namaskaram. That's the basic truth. If we receive, it should be handed over to the Lord. If not, ego gets blotted. It will cause a significant spiritual downfall. That is why Sadashiva Samaramba Shankaracharya Madhyama. So Pitasi also means Pujya Guru. So Lord is a creator of spiritual teaching tradition also. Therefore, Lord is Adi Guru. The Lord gives Vedanta teaching to Brahmaji, which is passed on through Guru Parampara. Yes, Gariyan means superior to all the Gurus. Because Srimad Shankaracharya, Guru Govinda Bhagavad Padam, they themselves are the Shishyas at one time. So everyone is a relative Guru other than Lord Shiva himself. So Arjuna says, you are Gariyan, the absolute Guru. You are never a Shishya, never had a Guru. So Guru Tamahadi Guruha. So third line is Na Tat Samasya Badya Kaha Kutonya. Means no one is equal to you. You are matchless and incomprehensible. Even infinity can never be a match. So neither someone is equal to you or superior than you. So Arjuna finally concludes by saying, Loka Treye Apye Pratima Prabhava. In all the three worlds, you are the Lord of matchless glory. So finally, I conclude by saying, if we don't get attracted to Lord Krishna, we get attracted to Maya. Hari Om, sir.
Thank you. Thank you, Dr. Bhaskar. Another beautiful verse, nicely explained. Smita, verse 44.
Gurubhyo Namaha. Arjuna surrenders his will, which is explained from verse 35 to 45. Surrendering is purely a mental state. And in our tradition, it is physically expressed in the form of namaskara, which is clearly explained in the 40th verse of this chapter. Now coming to the verse proper, the verse goes like this. Tasmat pranasya pranidhaya kayam prasadaye tvam aham isham idyam piteva putrasya sakheva sakyuhu priyaha priyayaha arhasi deva sodum. The meaning is like this. Therefore, bowing down, prostrating my body, I implore you, you adorable God, to forgive me, bear with me, as a father with a son, as a friend with a friend, as a lover with his beloved. Now, Arjuna's guilt does not live in, even though he has not done anything, any serious offense. He has only treated Lord Krishna as a friend. In fact, in bhakti literature, treating God as a friend is accepted, which is called as Sakya Bhakti, which is one of the 9 forms of devotional services, which is explained in Srimad Bhagavatam in 7th canto. It goes like this. Shravanam, Kirtanam, Vishnu Smaranam, Pada Sevanam, Archanam, Vandanam, Dasya Sakya Atma Nivedanam. Therefore, treating the Lord as a friend is acceptable, but still Arjuna feels guilty. Therefore, he says, Tasmat Pranasya, because I have offended you, insulted you, belittled you, I offer my Prayashchitta Namaskara. And what kind of Namaskara he offers? It is Pranidhaya Kayam, that is Sashtanga Namaskara. So having done Sashtanga Namaskara, Tvam Aham Prasadaye, I propitiate you as a compensation for the insult. Please forgive me, even though Bhagavan is not offended by him. Tvam Aham Isham means, O Adorable One, the only one who deserves Namaskara. Swamiji says, other than Bhagavan, no one deserves Namaskara. Any honor belonging to anyone ultimately comes from the Lord only. So Arjuna says, O Lord, you have to forgive me and forget the offenses as a father who forgives his children. As the children commit mistakes because of their immaturity, that is Piteva Putrasya, and then Sakeva Sakyuhu, just as a friend forgives the offenses and the insults of the friend. Lastly, like Priyaha Priyayaha, Priyaha means dear one. So here, wife is called Priyaha, that is dearer, as a husband who forgives his wife for her mistakes. So Arjuna says, you are like a father and you are like a husband also. Swamiji says, This is also a form of bhakti called Madhura Bhakti. When a man develops ecstatic love, he feels God as his own. It is like the gopis of Vrindavan identify with Krishna. They always claimed him as Gopinath and not as Jagannath. And this bhakti is called Madhura Bhakti. Lastly, Arjuna also says, "You are my friend." This shloka evokes an illustration from Mundaka Upanishad of two birds sitting on the branch of a tree. One bird symbolizes human condition and engrossed in enjoying the fruit of the tree, unaware of attachment it has developed towards the fruit, and that the fruit eventually becomes a cause of its sorrow. Bhagavad Gita has repeatedly pointed out that we do not realize that the more we get stuck into objects, the more the objects get stuck to us. The second bird on that branch symbolizes the Ishwara principle, who is not attached to the fruit and simply watching as a passive onlooker. Like Arjuna and like all of us, the first bird is stuck in delusion of the material world. The moment the first bird stops the indulgence and looks at the second bird, its bondage is snapped. Without the help of Ishwara principle, we cannot extricate ourselves from the pull of the senses. For most of us, this Ishwara principle is our teacher, our guru. So through this verse, we get the message to surrender ourselves in prostration to that Ishwara principle. Hari Om.
Thank you, Smita. You have nicely understood the verse and you have explained the verse to us. We go to the last verse for the day. Purnima, please go ahead.
Gurubhyo Namaha. We have come to verse 45 of chapter 11. In this chapter, we see how Krishna revealed to Arjuna the Vishwarupa and made him to realize what Vishwarupa means and who Krishna is. On seeing this Virata Rupa, Arjuna is terrified and is trembling with fear, as explained by Sanjaya in the previous verse. Here in this verse, we see him urging, begging Krishna to come back to his usual pleasant, beautiful Chaturbhuja Rupa. The verse reads like this: Adrushta Purvam Hrushitosmi Drushtva Bhayena Cha Pravyathitam Manome Tadevame Darshaya Deva Rupam Prasida Devesha Jagannivasa. Padaparichaya. Drushtva, seeing the universal form, Adrushta Purvam, which has not been seen before, Asmi Harshitaha, I am delighted, Cha, at the same time, Me Manaha, my mind, Pravyatitham, is afflicted, Bhayena, with fear, Deva, O Lord, Darshayame, show me, Tadeva Rupam, that familiar form itself, Devesha, O God of gods, Jagannivasa, Lord, who is the abode of the universe, Prasida, be gracious. So here Arjuna expresses his twofold emotions, which are simultaneously occupying his mind. On one hand, Arjuna says that I am one of the few chosen ones by Bhagwan who bestowed me with the Divya Chakshu, because of which I could have the rare vision of Vishwarupa Darshanam, a small speck of the divine expression, Eka Amshena, enveloping the entire cosmos. Anywhere and everywhere the presence of the Lord can be felt. So here Arjuna says, Adrushta Purvam Drushtva, I have seen something unique which I have not experienced before. And having seen this, Asmi Harshitaha, I am extremely delighted and exhilarated. On the other hand, I saw you as the dissolving fire of the universe, one who has consumed the whole thing to nothing, burnt everything into yourself. I am terribly frightened also. Bhayena cha pravyathitam manome. So with fear, my mind is afflicted, tortured, tormented, distressed. Pravyathitam. Fear is one of our most primal emotions. At some point or the other in our lives, we have encountered fear of losing our job, losing a loved one, fear of an angry confrontation, stage fear, and so on. But here, Arjuna is terribly afraid of losing his very existence. However, if we recall the teaching of the Gita so far, especially from the second chapter, we know that our true nature is the Atma, the eternal essence, which is infinite existence, knowledge, and happiness, Sat Chit Ananta. There is no scope for fear when we know our true nature as the infinite eternal essence. So then, the cause of the fear is the ego, the delusion that we are not the Atma. If we assume that I am the body, then all the problems and fears of the body, such as disease, old age, death, etc., become our problems. The fear of death, which is actually the fear of losing the existence of the body, becomes our fear. So then, why did Arjuna fear Sri Krishna's cosmic form? For a brief moment, Arjuna's ego had vanished when he considered himself part and parcel of the cosmic form. Since Arjuna was bestowed with a temporary gift of Divya Chakshu, he was not able to enjoy the Vishwarupa Darshanam totally. Here Swami Param says, one should earn Divya Chakshu by one's own sadhana, by sufficient karma yoga sadhana. Raga, dvesha, ahamkara, mamakara reduces and the mind develops a natural Divya Chakshu. Through this self-earned Divya Chakshu, Vishwarupa will not be frightening. Since Arjuna had not self-earned this Divya Chakshu, after a while his ego comes back. It brought with it all the incorrect associations of the body, mind, and so on. Arjuna then saw the cosmic form as something outside of himself, something that could destroy him. He acknowledged his fear to Sri Krishna. So finally, Arjuna says, Tadeva me darshaya deva rupam. May you show me your gentle and pleasing form. Prasida devesha jagan nivasa. Be gracious to me, he devesha, lord of all the lords. Jagan nivasa, lord who is the abode of the universe. Hari Om. Thank you, sir.
Thank you. Thanks, Purnima. Enjoyed listening to your explanation. Beautiful verses, nicely explained by all the speakers. We'll conclude today's class. Om Purnamada Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vashishyate Om Shanti Shanti Shanti. Om Sarve Bhavantu Sarve Santutam Vedam. Bhadrani Pashyantu Maa Kasthukha Bhagva Veda.